Hello, this is cafedecoreene. You can learn Korean in a coffee break and it's easiest pie. So, in a previous video, we learned Korean consonants and vowels. If you haven't watched this video yet, the link is below. And for today, we're gonna find out some Korean texting slangs and practicing this consonant we've learned. So, let's go. Okay, so this is a set of combinations of consonants and vowel a. Kanadara, babasa'a, tatakatapaha. So we are following this alphabetical order. So first one is gogo. Gogo. It came from English word gogo, so meaning is let's go or let's do it. Next one is 감사. 감사. It came from Korean phrase 감사합니다, which means thank you. So 감사 means thanks, and 감사 감사 means many thanks. And this one is 노노. 노노. It came from English word no no, so meaning is nope. 농농농. And this one is 노잼. 노잼. Meaning is not interesting at all. So, if you saw a movie that's full of cliché and it's too predictable, then you can say that it's 노잼. This one is 덜덜, 덜덜, or 후덜덜, 후덜덜. So, this is an onomatopoeia, that very cartoon-style expressions describing a shape of shivering from cold or fear, like. Next one is 대박, 대박, meaning is fantastic. So its literal meaning is big fortune, but we use it in both extremely good or bad situations. Like, for example, when I got 100% in math exam, then wow, 대박. Or I got 0 on my English exam, and wow, 대박. I mean, what kind of human in the world can possibly get 0? And next one is 레알, 레알. It came from English word real, so meaning is really. So if there's a question mark, it means really. And if there's no question mark, it means really, I mean it, can't agree with you more, I mean it, I'm sure, etc. This one is 몰라, 몰라, meaning is I don't know or I don't care. And next one is 미친, 미친, meaning is crazy. So if there's 놈 after 미친, it means whack or weirdo. And this one is 부들부들, 부들부들. This is also onomatopoeia, very cartoon style expressions of describing shape of quivering with rage, like. But in a more cute way, not in a serious way. Okay, next. 바이, 바바, 바이. They all mean bye. I mean, 바이 is bye, and 바바 is bye-bye, and 바이 is bye. I mean, we haven't learned double consonant yet, but we're gonna look at it sooner or later. Don't worry, nothing is difficult. Well, for now, just imagine a happy baby that learned human language for the first time and saying bye-bye in a very happy mood, like bye-bye. Next one is 수고, 수고. Its literal meaning is hard work. So if you are doing some hard work, it means cheer up or good luck. But if you've already done it, then it means good job or nice job. And notice, you cannot use it to your boss or elderly people. We use only to friends. This one is Anna. Anna. This is an exclamation that expressing that you are deeply upset or angry. So Anna itself is not a curse word, but it usually comes with curse word after it, like Anna, blah blah blah. Next, or oki, okey-dokey. So meaning is okay. One o means yeah, but sounds a bit careless, and two o is right, okay, and triple or more o is yeah, I mean it, I can't agree with you more. And this one is 인정, 인정. Literal meaning is respect. So it means really, or I mean it, and sometimes I'm proud of you. Okay, so this one is 아하. Meaning is 아하, very clear. So this one is 지송, 지송. It came from Korean phrase 죄송합니다, which means I'm sorry. So 지송 means sorry. So it's a casual way to say sorry or pardon. And this one is 출책, 출책, meaning is attendance check or I'm here. This one is 축하, 축하. Came from congratulations, 축하합니다. So 축하 is congrats, 축하 축하 is congratulate. So next one is 키키, 키키. The laughing sound. Well, I think you might have already seen this before because so many Korean people use this in everywhere, literally everywhere. So some people read it kuku or keke or whatever, but I read it kiki. So meaning differs, depends on the numbers of kick. So one kick means not that funny, being cynical, and two kick means it's quite fun, and triple kick or more is laughing out loud. Okay, so next one is 튀튀, 튀튀, or 튀튀, 튀튀. So it originated from gaming, meaning is run away. Imagine that your character's HP is in red color and there's two enemies coming to you, then you say 튀튀 or 튀튀. And nowadays, so many business people or students use these expressions. Like, suppose that it's Friday evening and you are on the way for a very playful weekend, then you can say that it's 튀튀 or 튀튀. Or imagine that you are escaping from classroom after the 출책, then you say it 튀튀 or 튀튀. And this one is 파이팅, 파이팅. It came from English word fighting. It's a kind of Konglish, and it's a kind of controversial whether it's 파이팅 or 화이팅, because there's no F sound in Korean. But I think we use them both. So meaning is let's go, or let's do it, or let's go fight against something. Let's go fight against COVID. So this is 폭풍, 폭풍. Literal meaning is storm, but it never be used alone. It always came with another noun after it. For example, 폭풍 눈물 means crying like a rainstorm. And this one is 헐, 헐. It's an exclamation, so can be used in everywhere. And this is 하이, 하이. Means high, so obvious. And last one is 하하, 하하. The laughing sound. Some people read it hoho or hehe, hihi, but I read it haha. Okay, so I try to pick the most widely used Korean texting slangs nowadays, but if there's something I missed, please leave some comment below. Then I'll see you soon. Bye!